Hey everyone, it's Monica Scrapping Frog Boys. So I'm back to share a handmade card. Now, last week you guys saw me share this box here for my Stuff It collab. I also showed it when I did my die feature series on the box itself. So I created the card, the coordinating card that goes with this box. I took basically the layout that I did on the decoration on the outside of the box and I made it into a card. So let me go ahead and share that. Before I get into it, let me go ahead and show you the dies that I used. For my sentiment, I used this Sue Wilson die, not older, just better. We have this Sue Wilson frames and tags, and I'm turning it to the sides, to try to avoid some of the glare. This is the frames and tags. It is the Phoebe, and I used the two outside dies, the outside edge as well as the decorative insert. One of my absolute all-time favorites from Sue Wilson. This is the Caribbean Island Collection background die, and I used the two outside pieces. For those of you that are not aware, that aren't familiar with Sue Wilson, her background dies do not have an outside cutting edge, so you either use a trimmer or a different nesting die to cut the actual outside out. This is an inset with all of the decorative pieces. To cut out my background as well as to do some matting, I used one of my most used nesting dies. This is a double pierced background rectangle. This is from her Noble Die Collection. It is double pierced. It has the piercing on both the inside of the die cut as well as the outside. For the greenery on the card, as well as on the box that you saw, this is the Cottage Cuts leafy foliage die. I have two of them. Then from there, the flower that I did is one of my handmade flowers. I always forget what file it is because I don't, these are older files that I have that I never labeled, so I don't know exactly whose they are. But this is the one that when I sell them, they're called the Blossom Number 3. So here is the card that I created. Now, this is my standard 7.5 by 5.5 card. The white cardstock that you see is Recollections 110 pound. This green here is Paper Tray Ink, or now as they're known, Ink to Paper in Spring Moss. And the bluish cardstock that you see all over, it is the Paper Tray Ink Hawaiian Shores to coordinate with the box. The gold foiling cardstock that you see, this is the 90 pound bright foil cardstock that I get from Paper and More. And as far as cardstock, that is essentially it. I do have my metal filigree corners, and I use various different sizes in the glass, clear glass flatback rhinestones. So let me go ahead and bring this up so you can see a little bit closer. For this one, instead of having the floral arrangement on the vertical card, I decided to make it horizontal, but I kept the grouping of three here. I tucked in the leafy foliage behind the flowers. Here is where you have the Caribbean background. It is cut out in white cardstock, backed in the Hawaiian Shores cardstock. This panel is popped up on dimensionals on top of the gold foil mat. The Hawaiian Shores matting on the background is adhered directly onto the card base. So just this panel is popped up on dimensionals. Then we have the Phoebe that I die cut the background in the Hawaiian Shores again, and then the decorative piece in white. This panel is also popped up on dimensionals on top of the background base. And again, I just clustered the flowers around the tag itself here. Here's where you have the sentiment. It's just one layer. I didn't do multiple layers, and adhered it directly onto the Phoebe tag. Here are the four metal filigree corners. As you can see, I have put, these are I think these are SS8 here, and that go around the entire perimeter of the oval part of the cards, of the die cut, I should say. And also in the little corners, I tucked one in on the four different points. Well, I didn't put it on this one because this one is covered, but on these points of the tag. And then we have two on the edge of the cardstock on all, well, I should say the card on all four corners. So here is the card itself. Not really much to it. Seems like it's a lot, but it's just some beautiful, decorative, elegant dies that make it look like it's a complicated card, which it definitely is not. The inside, I have not done anything to it yet. I will be matting it and then stamping a sentiment on the inside, but that is essentially it for my card. And it tucks in nicely inside my box. So here you have the coordinating set. I probably won't add any type of sentiment to the box itself. I'm just gonna leave it decorative as it is like that. And if you wanna kinda see the size, my cards are smaller than what the box is intended. So as you can see, it still leaves plenty of room. If I put it inside, it does jiggle around a little bit, but what I'll probably do is just add a piece of folded up cardstock. That way it brings it higher towards the top of the box and it doesn't sit out on the bottom. That way it doesn't, because like right here, if I close it, you can hear it shaking around inside. So I'll probably tuck something in on the bottom so the card doesn't fall to the very bottom and leave all that room on the top. So that is it for my little card set. Like I said, typically when I create cards, I always create a coordinating box. Very rarely do I ever come back and show the coordinating box to go with it, but essentially it's kind of the same layout that I do on the card. I just do it on the box, probably change a few things, whether it's a sentiment or I stamp something, or I might arrange it a little bit differently. Like on this one, on the box, it's vertical. The card is a horizontal card. So, but the layout is still generally the same. And I kind of just move some things around, but you get the point. That is about it. If you have any questions, please comment below. I did want to make sure to use some of the flowers that I create and have sold, because some people wanted to see what they look like on cards, since I don't really use them that often, except the Blossom 2, I think I used quite a bit. I use that one quite often, but I haven't really used this Blossom 3 and Blossom 4 on any projects. So here is some projects featuring the flowers, so you guys could take a look. Again, I'm rambling, so I'm gonna shut up now. If you have any questions, comment below, like I mentioned earlier, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.